When I first started out in video, I thought that good lighting was just having enough light so that my image didn't look grainy. But when it comes to making your videos look more cinematic, learning lighting techniques and angles is one of the quickest ways to make your videos look more professional. So let's take a look at the first episode of the new Disney Plus show Loki to see a simple lighting trick that you can do with a single light to make your videos look more cinematic. Hey everyone, Camber here, showing you how to use your camera to make good videos. And today, I'm gonna show you a simple lighting trick that I have seen time and time again in movies and shows that will instantly improve your videos. So we'll look at light placement, camera placement, as well as some other considerations such as lighting motivation. And as I get started, I wanna point out that I'm talking about using a single light for your subject because obviously there will be some other set lighting considerations as well. And before we even see the first character, the first thing to point out is that lighting is very important even for your set, and that means time of day when using natural lighting. Obviously, this is CGI, but you can see it's during golden hour, giving a light source from the side, which provides shadows on the backside of the dunes, making a nice contrast throughout the scene. Had this shot been made with the sun directly overhead, then you can imagine that the dunes would be very flat looking with no contrast. And now as the camera pushes in to see Loki, he's placed at an angle to the light sources as well that makes shadows on one side of his face. This is called low-key lighting, pun intended, where there's a high contrast of light to shadow on the face, and this specific look we see here is called Rembrandt lighting because Rembrandt used this lighting scheme often for his paintings, where the light source is from the side at a high enough angle to create a triangle light under the eye of the shadow side of the face. So in setting up your scene, figure out where your subject is going to be, and then play around with the angle of the light to one side until you get this look. The important thing to remember here is that you'll typically want to place the camera on the shadow side of the face when using an angled shot like this. When the camera's on the light side of the face, everything looks a lot flatter because we're looking at everything without much contrast because the shadows don't really stand out. But when the camera is moved to the other side, now the lit features of the subject stand out a lot more against the prominent shadows that we can clearly see from this angle. Then as the other people arrive to capture Loki, we see the same low-key lighting being used on them with more of a straight-on angle of the camera so that we still see the contrast in the face. And as the leader shows up, we see the Rembrandt look on her as well. And then as their conversation begins, now the camera is slightly angled from the shadow side of their faces. The funny thing here is that because the sun is behind Loki, it makes sense that the light would be shaped on their faces like this. However, with the sun being directly behind him, it doesn't make sense that his face is lit in the way that it is. This doesn't really stand out that much because he has been lit this way the entire scene, but the sun still does give motivated lighting for the hair, or rim light, that we see on the top of his head and shoulders that helps him stand out against the background. So if you do have a second light to use, setting it high and angled down behind your subject will give a nice outline around the subject to complement the low-key light source coming from the side. Have you ever wondered why your subjects don't look quite as good as you thought they would once you play back the footage? Well, I definitely have done this a lot of times when I first started, so let me know down in the comments how long it was before you first realized how important lighting is. But if you're new to lighting, this can be a lot to take in, so let's look at some more scenes with this lighting scheme in mind to help you better understand how to use it. In this scene, we see Owen Wilson's character Mobius backlit from a single window light source. Then we see one of the hunters with the low-key lighting style from that light source. And looking across the church, we can see multiple windows giving that same lighting scheme across the church, as well as providing a low-key light source for the child on the other end of the church. As Mobius walks up to the child, they're standing in front of another single light source with the camera angles from the shadow side of the characters. And when switching to the close-up angles, we once again see this low-key lighting style providing a lot of contrast to their faces to make the scene look interesting. And something that's not as noticeable here, though, is that there is also a soft overhead light on both characters, which is more obvious on Mobius because of his white hair. In this scene, Loki walks into somewhat of an interrogation, and the point where he initially stops in the room is under a source of light that provides the typical look of a straight down lighting that you would see in an interrogation type situation. And cinema is all about telling a story, so one of the best ways to make your videos more cinematic is to use every possible aid in telling your story, which includes lighting, just as we saw in the beginning of this scene. Then as Loki moves to sit down and begin talking, we see him now in the same low-key or high contrast setup with with the light source coming from the opposite side of the camera, which puts the camera on the darker side of the characters, once again making all their features stand out more. And something interesting to note in this scene is that you don't have to have a completely consistent lighting setup throughout the entire scene. As the camera moves to a 50-50 angle of the characters, we see that the light is closer to an overhead angle than the side angle that we saw before, as we can see more of Loki's forehead and how lit up Mobius's hair is. This is more obvious once we move back to the single angle shot, because Mobius' hair has much more shadows up the side all the way to the top of his head. This isn't a huge deal because it's not a big enough change for you to notice where you would think something is off. So don't be afraid to change up your light slightly to improve your shots depending on the angle of the camera for each take. And back to the storytelling aspect, once the conversation gets more personal and Loki feels like he's being attacked, he moves across the room and stands under the light again to provide that more interrogative lighting style as he starts to feel more and more powerless in this place that he now finds himself stuck in. And remember how I said you typically want to have the camera on the shadow side of the subject? Well, here's an example where we are on the light or key side of the subjects. However, in this case, because of the combination of a high-angled key light and a low angle from the camera, we still see some shadows on the bottom of the key side of their faces so that they don't look completely washed out with no contrast. And this just goes to show that even though there's a typical way to light and place the camera, this doesn't mean that you have to do that every time. And then as the scene continues, Loki changes his position to the camera that provides that Rembrandt look once again, where we were back on the shadow side of his face with the key coming from the opposite side. So hopefully you can see that lighting plays a huge role in the quality of your videos, and you've learned from Loki how to use the low-key lighting technique in order to make your videos look even better. I've incorporated this into my last short film, Bedtime, where I had a single light source for my subjects with a camera placed at angles on the shadow side of the characters to give that interesting, contrasty look. And if this is your first time hearing about this technique, I'm sure you're probably going to start to see it everywhere now when you're watching films, and you'll be able to start angling your subjects and lights in such ways to give them better lighting. But if this video is helpful, then please help me out. Hit the like button, leave comments, subscribe if you're new, share the videos, all that awesome stuff. Thank you guys for watching. The channel's growing quick. It's all because of you, and I'll see you soon.